Today I'm going to put two legends together, one living, one since passed. Cyndi Lauper is covering the self-titled track called At Last from Etta James's most incredible album. And I'm going to put a link to Etta James' channel for you in the description below, along with the description of Cyndi Lauper, because we need to just talk about the song itself. This is a song, and it was self-titled. Let's talk about the album first. The debut album was An American Blues by soul artist Etta James, released in November 1960. That's all we need to do. And it was ranked as the 60th best second album of the 1960s in total, that whole decade. So that's how popular it made Etta James. And when they did the song, by the way, they literally built an orchestra around her to go with her vocals, and it was considered her most, the jazzy sounds and the influences and the poppy influence was just considered phenomenal. Now, it also had, there was a compact disc in 1999 made of it with four bonus duet track performances. And My Heart Cries, Spoonful, It's a Crying Shame, and If I Can't Have You were all extra songs that was put on at last album. Now, the covers have been done by Lila James, Randy Crawford, Celine Dion, Connie Wilson, Christina Aguilera, and also covered by, and All I Could Do Was Cry was covered by Beyonce and Gladys Knight and the Pips. So Etta James has influenced a lot of people that we know. But this, today's track is so incredibly amazing for just two reasons. It proves that Cyndi Lauper was a pop icon in her own right, but she was a theatrical, glamorous, beautiful, soulful, jazzful singer and performer as well, as we're going to hear. The song At Last was certified gold by the RIAA, who are, and it should come up, the Recording Industry Association of America, and justifiably so. I have the lyrics in front of me. I'm looking forward to analysing. They're so short and sweet. And Cyndi Lauper put this as her first track on a 2003 LP she had out, doing covers of other songs like Making Whoopee, Hymn to Love, Unchained Melody, and her version of Unchained Melody is equally as impressive. But for me of the album, this is my favourite. Take a listen, enjoy, and you'll find out why. And I'll come back and I'll analyse the very short lyrics for you.
here we are in heaven. For you are mine.
I have to say, doesn't that disprove this competition that in her early career, she was always compared to Madonna? But there's no way Madonna can vocally be compared to Cyndi Lauper. Cyndi Lauper always had that deeper, like she could go as high as she wanted, but she had like a richness, a deepness, a kind of a jazzy feel to her voice. Madonna had a classic. I played, and I've attached Madonna's single to this, my favorite Madonna track, which is one of the most incredible vocal talents as we know in the world. But also Madonna proves as well that she's not all about pop and EDM and remixes and auto-tunes in her voice. She can sing, and she just sings with such soul. What is it? It'll come up on the video. Check out my playlist, and if you haven't subscribed, you should subscribe and comment as well. But Cyndi Lauper has that airiness about her voice in that it, she just delivered on so many levels. And I'll summarize what I think her voice is, because I remember when I'd heard other versions of it and I started listening to her album, I said, I find that she just easily moves from powerful blues shouting to more subtle, airy phrasing. That's how I'm going to describe that whole song. Now I'm just going to get into by Cyndi. And don't forget to check out Cyndi Lauper's At Last album. She also called her album At Last in 2003. Surprised for copyright, she got away with that. But she did, and probably because she took it after the Etta James. But you know, all this thing about copyrights now, it's unbelievable. So anyway, At Last 2003, Cyndi Lauper, put it on your list. And there's 13 wonderful tracks of covers on that album. That just disproves that she's not all about pop music. She can do theatrics, she in such a beautiful way. She can do jazz, she can do soul. And that's why I was so excited to play it to you. Now, I'll be even more excited if I can just get to the lyrics. Because it's all live, I jump from one to another. First one, At Last. My love has come along. My lonely day is over. My life is like a song. Oh, at last, the skies above are blue. My heart was wrapped up in clover the night I looked at you. So it's a romantic song. It's a beautiful song. It's a pop jazzy song. It's a theatrical song. But one thing that lyrics can do, no matter how or what genre you try to mix, is they can impact you straight away with just a few words. The skies above are blue. So that means brightness and happiness. My heart was wrapped up in clover. Clover is for good luck. I do this channel from Ireland. We're famous for the clover and the three-leaf clover. So you wrap up in clover, and it's supposed to be, I feel great, the skies are blue, I feel like I'm the luckiest person, I've won the lottery being in love with somebody like you. And it says, my lonely days are over, and my life is like a song. Because it continues, I found a dream that I could speak to, a dream that I could call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I had never known. I tell you, no matter how many relationships we go through in life to find that perfect person, it's when you hold them, it's when you touch them, it's when you kiss them on the cheek and they kiss you in the cheek, because it mentions here to press my cheek. It could be in a subtle kiss. And we all dream of being happy with somebody, and to find that dream, and to and the dream is came true and it brought you happiness, it's a thrill, as the lyrics say, I've never known. It is when it hits you. It is that thrill that none of us ever known, because we've had relationships before, but then when we find the real deal, it's the biggest thrill in the world, isn't it? So it continues, and verse 2, and it's the end of this. You smile, and then the spell was cast. And here we are in heaven, for you are mine at last. If you found your dream come true, don't become possessive. Don't hold on to it with all your worth and trip yourself up to please the person, to please the person, to please the person. It takes two to come together, and just remember to get as much out of your relationship as you give. So when you give, don't expect to get something back, because it can be rewarded in a smile or a hug or a thank you, a simple thank you. But don't always give. Just remember, when you found happiness, just enjoy the happiness. You don't need to keep proving yourself. Just live for the moment. And if you are married with kids, or you are in a gay relationship, or whatever kind of relationship, but you found that happiness, enjoy it. In the world today, we just need more of it, don't we? So enjoy every minute of it. Take care.